Hello, Kolau Baptist. Glad you could join us for our devotion time. I've been talking a lot about this COVID-19 because it has sort of challenged us and brought us to do a whole lot of new things. One of them is the devotion time. I'm glad that we're able to have these devotions. I know we've been sending some of them, I think, via text or through the email. If that is a burden, we wouldn't want you to have to take us off the email list, but if you would just rather us send these devotions, have them posted, and you can check them when you want to rather than come in on your phone or your email, let us know. We're trying to figure out the best way we do it, but main thing is I'm thankful for the encouragement, and I'm thankful that some have been able to call in and say they appreciate the devotions. We're looking here at 1 Corinthians 15 and verse 58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know, your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Now notice where the Bible says, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Always abounding in the work of the Lord applies to now, even during this sort of lockdown, quarantine, social distancing, whatever you want to call it. This is time for us to abound in the work of the Lord. We can still pray, we can still go, and we can still serve. If we neglect service, even during this difficult time, then we're going to really not be doing what God wants us to do, and we're going to find ourselves in a weakened condition. Very, very important to do that. There was a fellow named Unamuno, and he was a famous Spanish philosopher, and tells a story about an ancient Roman aqueduct at Segovia in his native Spain. It was built around 109 AD. For 1800 years, it carried cool water from the mountains to the hot and thirsty city. Nearly 60 generations of men drank from the flow of this aqueduct. Then came a new generation into modern times, who said the aqueduct is such a great marvel that it ought to be preserved for our children as a museum piece, and we shall relieve it of its centuries-long labor. So they laid down modern iron pipes, and they gave the ancient bricks and mortar a reverent rest. And the aqueduct began to fall apart. It seems that the sun beating on the dry mortar caused it to crumble. The bricks and the stones sagged and threatened to fall. What ages of service could not destroy, idleness disintegrated. That's a great illustration because it's true of us. That aqueduct was strong, for 19 centuries, can you imagine? That's a long time to carry water. And yet, as soon as they shut the water off, the thing began to disintegrate and to crumble. And it's a great illustration because that's the way it is in the Christian life. A lot of folks find themselves not growing in the Christian life. They find themselves missing out on something. They look at other Christians and they wonder, why is it that it's not as meaningful to them? And the reason for that is they're not engaged in service. God made us to be servants, and He built us to serve. And when we serve, then our walk with God begins to make more sense, things begin to click, and our life begins to be more vibrant because we're engaged in service. That's true in every area of service. It's true in the gospel and spreading the gospel in the world. The Lord told us to go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. That calls for action. That calls for movement. That calls for service. And so I have a little visual aid here that I want to show you. And the emphasis in Mark's gospel there in the Great Commission is to go. And if you ever think about it, it's impossible to spell the word gospel without the word go right built in there. And so go is built into the gospel. Even thinking about the Lord, His name, God, well, it's impossible to spell that. We see go. Or We think about the Good Samaritan, the one that the Lord commends for taking care of someone that was hurt and injured. You can't spell Good Samaritan without the word go. And that's just a visual to help remind us that we need to be going. Now, I know these are times in which we are asked to not go. We're asked to stay home. We're told to stay home as much as possible, limit our trips to the store. If we're a non-essential business, to just cease. And if we're rendering services, only the essential things. And a lot of just sitting, a lot of just staying at home, not as much going. And for those that do have to go, well, they're in important positions of essential things. And they can tell a lot of people are not going because the freeways are clear and it's smooth sailing on the highways at this time. But for the believer, even though we may have to stay close to home, and even though we may be expected not to go as much, and there's certainly places that we cannot go, we still can go in our service. We can phone a friend. We can send a letter, a card. We can go help someone that needs their yard mowed. We can do 1,000 things in order to serve someone else. This coming Sunday is Mother's Day, and I want to wish an early happy Mother's Day to all of our moms out there. We appreciate you so much. We are thankful for what you're doing. But this Sunday is Mother's Day, and here's a way that you can serve the Lord. You can get on your email, your social media, on the phone, and you can invite friends to watch us either on Facebook or on YouTube, and they can view our services. I'll be bringing a special message on moms. I think we have some special music lined up. And in that message on moms, I have built in the gospel message, which is what I'm going to do the next 4 Sundays. I'm going to be bringing clear salvation messages, simple salvation messages. It's because I want you to do your best to serve the Lord, to abound in God's work, even during this difficult time, by inviting a friend to come. It may be that we're going to be allowed to meet before those 4 weeks are up. And if that's so, we'll continue to do that. But invite a friend to tune in and learn about what Jesus has done for them. Well, I'm thankful for all of you. We just got the report here on our finances for the month of April, and God's people have been really faithful. Some of you have given extra offerings, and I just want to say I'm so thankful for you abounding in God's work, and that's enabling us to pay everyone and pay our bills and see the ministry go forward, to spend some money here and there to be a blessing. And so I'm thankful, and just keep up the good work. If you need anything, however, be sure and call us, because we're here to help and be a blessing to our families. Well, God bless you, and thank you for tuning in, and I'll look for you on Sunday on the internet. Aloha.